Hello viewers, welcome to AP's Ophthalmology Pearls. Today we shall discuss the various positions of gaze and the concept of yoke muscles. First, we shall discuss the various positions of gaze. There are 9 diagnostic positions: the primary position, straight up or elevation, straight down or depression. The primary position is the position of the eyes when fixating straight ahead at any object 6 meters or more away with a straight head posture. The others are looking up and to the right, term dextro elevation, directed to the right, term dextroversion, down and to the right, term dextro depression, up and to the left, term levo elevation, directed to the left, term levo version, down and to the left, term levo depression. The 9 diagnostic positions are for measurement of deviation. These 6 positions are termed the cardinal positions of gaze. They are so called as in each of these positions, one extraocular muscle is the prime mover of each eye. These pairs of muscles, one in each eye, that produce conjugate ocular movements are termed yoke muscles. Once again, yoke muscles are a pair of muscles, one in each eye, that produce conjugate ocular movements. So let us first consider dextroversion. The muscles required for this are the right lateral rectus and the left medial rectus. So these two are considered the yoke muscles for dextroversion. For levoversion, the left lateral rectus and the right medial rectus are yoke muscles. Determining the yoke muscles for horizontal movements is very easy. For the other cardinal positions, it is not that easy. First, we shall understand the yoke muscles for these positions, and then I will give you an easy way to remember them. So first, let's take dextro elevation. You will recollect from my previous video, the link of which I have given above as well as in the description box, that in abduction, the maximum elevating action of the superior rectus and depressing action of the inferior rectus occurs. Similarly, in adduction, the superior oblique is a better depressor than any other muscle, and the inferior oblique is a better elevator. So, the recti are the most efficient in producing vertical movements in abduction, and the obliques produce the most efficient vertical movements in adduction. Since the right eye is in an abducted position, the superior rectus is the prime elevator for the right eye, and the inferior oblique is the prime elevator for the left eye because it is adducted. So these two are the yoke muscles for dextro elevation. By a similar argument, the right inferior rectus and the left superior oblique are the yoke muscles for dextro depression. In levo elevation, the left eye is abducted and the right eye is adducted. So, the left superior rectus and the right inferior oblique are the yoke muscles. In levo depression, the left inferior rectus causes the depression in abduction, the right superior oblique causes the depression in adduction. And so, these two are the yoke muscles for this position. So now you have understood how the yoke muscles are what they are. Now I'll teach you a shortcut to remember in an emergency. We won't consider dextroversion and levoversion because that is straightforward and easy. For the other positions, first always determine the yoke muscle, that is the rectus. For that, since the vertical recti cause vertical movements in abduction, determine the yoke muscle for the eye in abduction as follows. For dextro elevation, dextro is right. Elevation is by superior rectus. So the prime mover of the right eye in dextro elevation is the right superior rectus. To obtain its yoke muscle, simply take the opposite of every one of its components. So instead of right, we shall put left. Instead of superior, we shall put inferior. And instead of rectus, we shall put oblique. So the right superior rectus and the left inferior oblique are the yoke muscles for dextro elevation. In levo depression, levo is left. Depression is by inferior rectus. Taking the opposites for the yoke muscle, it is right. Inferior becomes superior, rectus becomes oblique. So the yoke muscles for levo depression are left inferior rectus and right superior oblique. In levo elevation, it is left for levo, superior rectus for elevation, and the yoke muscle is right. Superior becomes inferior, rectus becomes oblique. So the left superior rectus and the right inferior oblique. In dextro depression, it is the right for dextro, inferior and rectus for depression, and the yoke muscle is left, and the inferior becomes superior, rectus becomes oblique. So right inferior rectus and left superior oblique are the yoke muscles for dextro depression. So that's it for today. If you like what you saw, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from AP's Ophthalmology Pulse. You may watch my other videos by clicking on the thumbnails. Please leave a note in the comment section if you wish for any particular topic to be covered in future. Look forward to regular updates. Thank you for watching.